Hello and welcome to yet another episode with me, Miss Envy. It's great to have you here. All you have to do is sit back, relax, and allow me to do the scrolling. Where does the scrolling come from? Or the content for that matter? Well, it's my algorithm. It decides what I need to see. And then when I see it, I think, who else should see this? So, let's get curious. So we start off with a bit of humor for the day. The next video is rather important, and I urge everyone to please take heed. There's a crisis on our hands, a worldwide one. Good evening. I'm Miss Envy, reporting to you breaking news. Today, our world faces an unprecedented crisis, a pandemic sweeping across nations, leaving chaos and mild inconvenience in its wake. Experts have tentatively named this condition Karenditis. Karenditis is an infectious affliction that appears to alter personalities, increasing levels of irrational complaints, entitlement, and public tantrums. Symptoms may include demanding to speak to the manager without reason, a compulsion to critique service standards, and in severe cases, an urge to film confrontations. Karenditis, however, appears to be highly contagious, transmitted through crowded retail spaces and comment sections on social media. Right now, health officials, I'm getting feedback now, live information, yes. Health officials are urging the public to take precautions. If you or a loved one has shown early symptoms, such as unexpected annoyance at minor inconveniences or a sudden need to critique coffee shop protocols, please isolate until the urge passes. Please pay careful attention to the next video as we see this horrific transformation take place. And remember, stay vigilant, stay safe, and remember to breathe if the urge of complaining arises.
Oh, look, some skateboarders.
You can't skateboard here.
What was that?
I want to talk to the manager.
No. No, what's happening to me?
There goes the neighborhood. You're trespassing, okay? This is a private neighborhood. Don't film me!
On my sidewalk. Thank you. I called the cops. I called the police.
It's a problem, people. We really need to avoid getting Karenditis. I think they say one of the main ways to get it, or the biggest problem, is the haircut. So just avoid that haircut, okay? I think that might help a lot. All right, so let's stop monkeying around, shall we? This is cool. I like this. Oh, I just thought I'd pop that in there because, you know, why not? Right. So here's a question for the next scene. Do any of you love the color blue? And are you perhaps also diagnosed as ADHD? Well, I am.
Color and light are just vibration at a higher level. And so our program, if you show the frequency wheel, is also color coded. Why do you like blue? Or why are you wearing pink today? And this is very common with people with attention deficit disorder. They love the color blue. Love the color blue. Their rooms are blue. Their clothes are blue. Their car is blue. When you ask them what's their favorite color, they point to my royal blue mouse pad and say, that's my favorite color. And when I look at their voice, they are low in the notes of D and D sharp, which are the colors of blue. If we were to take those notes, the note of D on the piano, and keep increasing its octaves, we would finally end up at a color called blue. And they surround themselves with blue. By giving them the frequency of blue by color, by giving it to them by sound, you know, down in what we call the DD sharp range, finding what's missing in their voice there, by placing blue overlays over their work, it seems to unscramble their brain. It increases their comprehension dramatically. Attention deficit disorder in the kids I see is very easily controlled by the blue color frequency. We call it their blue frequency, which they get in sound, blue overlays. They begin to replace the color blue in their energy fields. And that unscrambles the brain. I've seen a big problem with the color pink right now, which is related to EMF fields. Waveforms are very helpful, or they can be very harmful, and I think that's an important consideration. Men working around microwave all have decreased sperm counts and infertility problems. We've seen the cancer clusters located around the extremely low frequency waveform fields the government's been generating. And I think that the use of frequency is a double-edged sword. It could be used to help us as much as to hurt us. And it's hard to counteract all the EMF fields we're exposed to. They're everywhere, and these waveforms are in the air. But by rebalancing your own unique frequency patterns and how you're responding to all of this, you're able to protect yourself a little bit more. And I think detoxing is going to be one of the biggest gifts that we get from the sound work.
Another interesting aspect is, in a healthy person, what you would see is kind of yellow all the way around the chart on all of the different levels. And what happens is you can just, by looking at this particular chart, really see how the person is kind of scattered in their voice and in their brainwave entrainment and such. One of the things that we do is just help to bring this more and more and more into equilibrium by listening to this little device between, you know, 2 minutes or 2 hours a day or something. You can listen to it as you go to sleep at night. You can listen to it while you're working or doing whatever. Another really kind of funny thing is, if you look at relationships, one of the funny things is that, like, one person will have this, say, this area here very high. Well, it turns out that their mate will have just about everything else but that. And that what ends up happening is you kind of end up with these relationships where the two complement each other in order to make the whole. And that's, you know, kind of the standard codependent relationship. Two people that need each other and end up leaning on each other.
So colors and frequencies, even they predict relationships, or how should I say this? Codependent relationships are the way they are. We depend on others in a relationship for something that should be balanced and whole within ourselves to begin with. Now, we don't have access to that device that they're talking about, but you know what you can do here on TikTok? You can actually go and search for what frequencies are good and search for them on TikTok, and you get lovely videos put together with sound, and you just listen to that. I think you can even do that with YouTube. Listen to it, sit yourself right, get yourself balanced, and start the day. Start it well. Right, any of you living in South Africa that don't like to get interrupted, check this out. We all know what it's like to live with Hardy Dars. Okay, so for the next video, I would like to ask you a question. Have you guys ever heard of something called facial diagnosis. This guy looks like a professional who studied this. I think he says in the video 20 years. He studied it for a prolonged period of time, and he gets a lot of joy out of doing this. But look at the subject he's chosen for today's discussion. This is quite interesting. Enjoy.
Sean P. Diddy Combs. He's in the news. It's always difficult to do a facial diagnosis on someone that's done something untoward. In this case, this guy owns the dealership on untoward. So it's hard not to see the negatives. It's hard to be intellectually honest, but I'm going to just do a facial diagnosis on him. And let's try to understand who he is and why he did some of the things he did. So P. Diddy is a bucket face. There's 9 face shapes. It's shaped like a bucket. I have a bucket head. So these people tend to be pretty bright, very curious, intellectually persistent, thought leader. But we tend to overthink. I always say we can think of creative problems for every solution on Earth. But you can't look at this picture and not notice the eyes. So I'm going to go through a number of things here that'll help you understand exactly who he is. So if you'll notice his eyes, the whites, there should be white on the right and the left, but not on the top or the bottom. In his case, he's got white 3 sides. It's known as lower simpaku. It's actually a Japanese term, means white 3 sides. This is a sign of fanaticism and addictions. So he's fanatical and he's prone to addictions. I couldn't whistle a tune that this guy sang. I'm not a fan of rap, and I'm not a fan of opera. Look, I offended a whole group of people in 2 different areas, but I don't listen to him, and I couldn't whistle a tune. But his eyes tell me that I'm not fond of him. Now, let's take this a little deeper. When we look at a face, the right eye is what we want to show to the world. It's our public persona, it's our mother's influence. The left side is our true inner private self. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to cover this guy's left eye, and when we look at his right eye only, this is intense and it's anger. But the disturbing is when you look at the other side. There's hate, there's disdain, there's just an uncaring energy. I believe this guy could push you down the stairs just with the same emotion that he gave you a hand to lift you up when you fell. It's an uncomfortable look. And I get it. We all have an opinion on this guy, and we've already tried him and convicted him. But I'm just telling you what I see on his face. If I didn't know who he was, I would give you the same diagnosis. His eyebrows are kind of peaked. So this guy is a person that likes action and attention. This is common to that kind of energy. His nose tip, he's got a very gourmand nose. So he likes the finer things in life. He will be very addicted to the finer things in life and those things that can get you there. His ears are different heights. So this often indicates either a difficult or severed relationship with parents. My guess is his parents were either divorced or one of them wasn't there, him growing up. I don't know him. I don't know anything about him in that regard. But here's the interesting thing. Sometimes the diagnostic indicator is what should be there and isn't. And this is, for me, the most disturbing thing on this man's face. If you notice my lines that come from here down, they're incredibly deep. They look like somebody chiseled them in there. These are called falling lines. Falling means purpose and spiritual strength. By the time you're 30, you should have some. I know I'm on this earth. I know what my Creator put me on this earth to do. I am passionate about it. I have deep, deep spiritual strength. These come from wanting to help mankind. This guy has no helping mankind in any cell in his body. It is a disturbing marker. And again, sometimes it's what should be there and isn't becomes a diagnostic indicator. And again, not a fan of doing this kind of diagnosis. Health-wise, he's got some liver issue. The emotional liver is anger. If you look at his eyebrows, they're very thick. Eyebrows are about passion, pride, temperament. What's the root of temperament? Well, it's temper. This guy's got a temper that will be at the forefront. This guy would, he's just got deep-seated anger issues that go back way before he was famous. Very strong constitution, can push his body way past its physical limits. I'm sure he put things into his body that to the normal person would take him out, not him with his strong constitution. Pretty long, pretty significant lung weakness. So again, sad to do these faces, but it's also probably important because if we see this in other people, we can speak into their lives and maybe turn them away from making the decision this guy made.
So while parts of the world are fighting Karenditis pandemics and others are trying to get folks like P. Diddy incarcerated, the rest of us are asking the following.
This video is for all of the adults, so if you're not an adult, keep scrolling because this video is not for you, okay? All right? Is it just us? Just us adults? Yeah? Okay, what are we doing? What are we doing? Like, what are we supposed to be doing? I don't know. You know, when we were younger, the adults in our life would be like, hey, you'll understand when you're older. Well, we're older now. We don't understand shit. What are we doing? We just go through every day pretending we're cosplaying as adults with their shit together. Don't let anybody else know. We don't have our shit together. We don't know what we're doing. You're supposed to live and learn. Well, we're living. I ain't learning shit.
Right, as a child growing up, did you ever come across that movie called Stargate?
Ever wondered why all these unexplainable ancient structures are built on the Earth's energy grid? The explanation stems from the Emerald Tablets of Thoth, who was also known as Idris, Enoch, Hermes, Metatron, or Quetzalcoatl. In these tablets, Thoth mentions a technology called stargates many, many times. He explains that they enabled him to travel instantaneously between various locations on Earth and even to other worlds. And this is how these stargates worked. The stargates use Earth's energy grid, a network of natural energy lines that crisscross the planet. By aligning the stargates with these energy lines, Thoth could tap into a limitless source of power, enabling instantaneous travel. These energy lines are now called ley lines to hide their true power, but it gets even crazier. Look at all these ancient sites, they all lie on Stargate locations. This is because Thoth built every single one. He traveled the globe spreading spiritual wisdom, advanced technology, and profound astronomical knowledge. This is also how every site aligns with constellations or celestial objects. Thoth was known by many names in different cultures because he used these stargates to travel and build sites. Do you think Thoth built more sites on other planets?
Interesting. Don't you just love it when sci-fi movies from back in the day start to come true? Okay, for the last video, I thought I'd share something special from my youth, from when I was a kid. My grandfather used to take me on lots of walks and the dogs would come along. I would get bored easily. I didn't like the sun. I didn't like the ants biting my ankles. And it was my grandfather's mission to try and entertain me that bit much more, that little bit more, just to make me appreciate the experience. And he introduced me to one of these. If any of you know what this is, please write what you think it is in the comment section. But pay attention to the center of the hole. They're so cute. And it was so much fun to find them. You had to pretend you were an ant walking across this trap and lure this little creature out. It has a specific name, and I used to love doing this as a child. Anyway, those of you that know, know. Right, everybody, thank you so much for joining me again for another episode where we stayed curious. And yeah, you'll see me again shortly with some more awesome content. Thanks, everybody. Take care. Bye.